Death Ride by Paul Ieson. You wake up to a very uncomfortable situation. Your knees are up into your chest and you are touching the top of the box that you are in. The top of your head is touching the side and it hurts because it feels like it is being shoved right up against it. While all this is going on and you are trying to keep yourself together without freaking out, you can also tell that the box you are in is being carried. But by whom? While the box is rocking in all directions, you can hear someone, even though the voice is a bit muffled, complain because the box is so heavy. Then, through all the mind racing going on in the brain, there is a tad bit of relief as you have been set down onto the ground, but you have no idea where. Then you hear someone saying something else, but you can't quite understand them. A few minutes of silence is now taking place before you hear the sound of an engine starting. You realize that you can recognize the sound of the motor and know that it is your riding lawnmower. It dawns on you that you have been placed on your own trailer and they are going to move you the rest of the way, wherever that is, with the tractor. You now also figured out that the chest that you are in is the old empty trunk you had stored in the garage. You are screaming at yourself to try to figure out who is doing this to you and have a few ideas, but you cannot be sure. Then the thoughts in your own head are interrupted by the sound of someone getting on a tractor and you begin to move. You begin to struggle to make enough room to attempt and kick the side and top of the chest so that you can break free, but you can't. Screaming is pointless because the mower is so loud. All you can hope at the moment is that the nosy neighbor next door comes out to see what is going on. However, you are not too hopeful for this to happen. So you try to figure out what led up to this and how this happened. You have absolutely no memory of anything leading up to being put in the trunk. None at all. And now you are in a constant state of what the fuck. Then finally you remember something. You had a headache and you asked someone to get you an aspirin. Only now you do not think it was an aspirin, but something to make you sleep. In fact, you are pretty sure that is what happened. But before you can remember who gave it to you, the lawnmower stops, turns around, and backs into somewhere before the motor goes quiet. The ride was very rough and you are glad that it is over, but you still are trying to figure out a way to get out of the mess that you are in. Then you hear two people talking, but not loud enough that you can understand what they are saying. However, you assume it was about moving you by hand again. You can now feel yourself being lifted up and dragged at the same time. This only lasts a minute before you can tell they have picked you all the way up again, without warning, not that there would be any. You feel yourself falling, but not for long, just long enough to be put into a huge state of pain. This makes you go unconscious again. You come to with the sound of the dirt being dumped under the chest, and you realize that this may just end up being your grave. The sound goes on for about 10 minutes before you can no longer hear anything at all, and you realize now just how fucked you really are. It does not take long before the air becomes thin and you are having trouble breathing. The only thing that is coming to mind now is the question why. Soon you pass out. Then you become awakened by the sound of digging. You wonder to yourself how much time has passed, but you haven't a clue. Soon you feel yourself being lifted up and out of the hole and then set down onto the open ground. At first, people are having trouble breaking the lock off the chest, but then you hear it break free. When they open the lid, you find yourself standing outside of the chest and next to a police officer. This is when you learn that you are dead, and you now have the intentions of haunting everyone.